Thanks to NordVPN for sponsoring this video. Hey there! This is the Watersmeet Dome in Michigan, and it includes the oldest known rock in the United States. For now. It's messy. But like any good drama, it's messy in an interesting way, because it can tell us more about what the Earth was like more than 3.5 billion years ago. It's story time. I was planning to record the whole video out here, but it is black fly season, y'all. So let's head inside. So, like the name suggests, the Watersmeet Dome is a geologic formation outside of Watersmeet, Michigan, a small town in the Upper Peninsula. It includes a type of rock called gneiss, which looks nothing like how it's spelled, but does make for some very nice geology puns. Gneiss is a metamorphic rock, which means it started off as something else, but then it was exposed to situations like extreme heat, pressure, or even hot fluids, and its properties and structure changed. Gneiss can form different ways from different starting rocks, but here in Watersmeet, the original ingredient was igneous rock, aka cooled lava or magma. Over the decades, geologists have estimated that the Watersmeet gneiss is at least 3.6 billion years old, which is really saying something because the Earth is only about 4.5 billion. To clarify, not all of the Watersmeet Dome is this old. It is a complex structure. But regardless, to find any rock this old up at the surface is extremely rare. Usually, rocks like this have been eroded away or destroyed long before this point, or they're buried deep within the Earth. So places like this are incredibly useful for geologists trying to understand the early chapters of our planet's history. But how did geologists figure out how old these rocks are in the first place? Well, to date really old igneous or once igneous rocks, they use a method called uranium lead dating. If you're familiar with carbon dating, it's a similar concept. Uranium lead dating relies on the fact that certain minerals contain a bit of uranium. Or really, they contain two versions or isotopes of uranium, one called uranium-238 and another called uranium-235. The numbers represent how many total protons and neutrons are in each atom, so 238 has more neutrons. What's more important here, though, is that both kinds of uranium are unstable, and over time, they slowly turn into lead. And this transformation happens at a very predictable, steady rate. So by comparing the amounts of uranium and lead in a mineral sample, you can figure out how old it is. And the cool thing about uranium is that because there are two types of it, you effectively have two clocks. You're not just relying on one number. Uranium lead dating is the standard for ancient rocks like this. In particular, uranium lead dating done on zircon crystals inside these rocks. Zircons are crystals that form in magma. When they form, they contain a bit of uranium and zero lead. And also, they are super durable. They can last for billions of years, which makes them very helpful tools for figuring out how old rocks are. Zircons in the Watersmeet gneiss are how geologists determined that this rock is at least 3.6 billion years old. But, I did say this was messy. This spring, an article was published in the magazine GSA Today, and a lot of local news sources were quick to celebrate that Michigan has the oldest known rock in the country. But by just focusing on that title, I think we missed something cool here. In this article, the authors looked at zircons from three different spots in the US: Wyoming, Minnesota, and just outside of Watersmeet, Michigan. These are the diagrams showing the samples they looked at. The data points are represented by ovals, because there's some room for uncertainty in each measurement. But even beyond that, you'll notice that for some samples, the ovals are all over the place. Like in this sample from Watersmeet, the data are fairly consistent. The ovals are in the same couple of spots. But in this sample, there are zircon measurements that say the Watersmeet gneiss is about 1.3 billion years old, all the way up to 3.8 billion, which is quite the range. Meanwhile, if you look at the data from the oldest rocks in Wyoming, well, both samples look more consistent, putting this rock at about 3.4 or 3.8 billion years old. So why do the authors conclude that Watersmeet, Michigan has the oldest known rocks in the country? I've read enough about science to know that if your results are all over the place, you should probably trust them less than something that's giving you consistent data, right? Well, there's more to the story here. Remember how there are two types of uranium slowly turning into lead? Well, if geologists date a zircon and the two measurements both match what you'd expect to see given the predictable rate of uranium decay, that data point is called concordant, and it makes everyone's lives easier. But if the two types of uranium don't give the same age, and therefore don't match the curve, that data point is discordant. But it doesn't necessarily mean the data are bad. If the data point falls below the curve, that just suggests that some of the lead got lost from the zircon over time. Lead doesn't actually fit very well into the crystal structure of zircons, so if there's some notable geologic event after that crystal forms, the lead can get knocked out and go missing, especially if the rock got heated up. And that will skew your results from uranium-lead dating, making the zircons seem younger than they really are. Side note, it is possible for uranium to get added to the zircon, which would also mess up this number, but that is more rare. Regardless, the thing about ancient rocks is that in the last 3.5 billion years, they've kind of experienced a lot. Like, look at Watersmeet. The Watersmeet gneiss is near the Great Lakes tectonic zone, which has experienced multiple episodes of being compressed, then pulled apart, then compressed again over the last 2.7 billion years or so. And that kind of compression is usually associated with rocks being buried and heated, which again is a great way to mess with the balance of uranium and lead in a zircon. So the zircons at Watersmeet have had countless chances to lose lead, and really, so have all of these ancient rocks. So the fact that the data for this sample are all over the place doesn't necessarily mean that the results are bad. This just suggests that the zircons have had a complicated history. But what do geologists do when their data are discordant? When it seems like lead has been lost and uranium-lead dating doesn't give them perfect textbook results? How do you make sense of this? Well, all the data points, all the little zircon measurements, they should point toward the same age, right? But depending on how much lead each little zircon grain or fragment lost, those points will have been knocked off the curve different amounts. And here's the key. If you can draw a straight line through the discordant data, you can effectively see through the effects of lead loss. Wherever that line intersects the curve, that is how old your zircon really is. And all the points on that line represent different zircon grains or fragments that have lost different amounts of lead. These authors refer to this as a regressed age. And if you do this with this sample from Watersmeet, the line intersects the curve at about 3.6 billion years old, which happens to match up with some fairly concordant data we have from another sample. So again, discordant data aren't necessarily bad. They just tell us the rocks have had a complicated history. Although, to be fair, this is still a confidence hit. Stuff like this is why figuring out the age of ancient rocks is just so darn messy. A lot has happened in the last few billion years. Now, the last thing to note here is that both Michigan and Wyoming have at least one data point at about 3.8 billion years old. And here, the authors suggest that these zircons in particular don't seem to belong to the rock they were found in. Remember how I said zircons were super durable? Well, sometimes they're so durable that they outlive the rock they formed in. So mostly, this just suggests that some rock also formed here about 3.8 billion years ago, and then was destroyed at some point along the way. So until somebody actually finds that 3.8 billion year old rock, it's not actually a contender in the oldest rock in America competition. So where does that leave us? Well, Coming in at least 3.6 billion years old, these authors propose that Watersmeet, Michigan has the oldest known rock in the United States. But, one more but here. I don't think this is actually interesting because it's a superlative we Michiganders now get to own. One, it's entirely possible older rocks exist. Titles are fleeting. But two, I'm more interested in the fact that these very old, similarly aged rocks were found spread across the country. Because that does suggest something. This suggests that this belt from Wyoming to Michigan may have once been one ancient piece of land, or at least one ancient piece of the Earth's crust. The authors even go so far as to call it the nucleus around which the younger rocks of the nation were assembled. And I like that. I like the idea that instead of competing for a title, we're actually just learning more about Earth's ancient history, and that we're all more connected than we thought. Thanks again to NordVPN for supporting this video. I've talked about them a couple of times before, and that's because I really appreciate the way their products keep me, my information, and my computer safer, and I thought you might also be interested. Their big thing is virtual private networks, or VPNs, which allow you to connect to the internet like you're signing on from locations around the world. And I use a VPN. But in particular, I really like their threat protection feature. It blocks some advertising trackers from collecting info about what I do online, it prevents me from downloading viruses, and it stops me from visiting sketchy websites that might be trying to steal my data. And one subscription covers 10 devices, including computers and phones, which means I can also cover members of my family with no added cost. Overall, I think it's a useful tool in my internet security tool belt. If you want to try them out, you can learn more at nordvpn.com/AlexisDahl. They have a 30-day money-back guarantee if you don't like it, and also at that link, they are offering the best deal they're currently running on the internet, which is a big discount on a 2-year plan, plus 4 months for free. Again, that's nordvpn.com/AlexisDahl. Thanks for considering supporting the sponsors who help fund projects like this. And as always, thanks for being here. I hope you learned something that makes you think about the world just a little differently. And I'll see you soon.